over here. means, let's hear it. It's the least I could do since you already helped me grant one final wish for my last worshippers. They were suffering so from vampirism and begged me for a cure. Then you came and ended their misery. I couldn't have planned it better myself. So, what's your heart's desire? What kind of deal can we strike? That insufferable pup, forget it. Request denied, no deal. I'm glad to be rid of him. Even if it does mean I'm stuck in this pitiful shrine in the back end of nowhere. Well, perhaps there is a way he could earn his place back at my side. Maybe, but no promises. There's an axe. An incredibly powerful axe. An axe powerful enough for me to have quite a bit of fun indeed. If you bring it to me, I'll grant you my boon. No strings attached, no messy surprises. At least not for you. As I recall, it's resting in Rhyme Rock Burrow. Barbers can lead you right to it. Little Mutt might even earn his place back at my side. Rueful axe from Rhyme Rock Burrow, and I believe we'll have a deal. In Rhyme Rock Burrow, there's an artifact called the Rueful Axe. Bring it to me, and I'll take Barbara's back. Simple as that. One of Clavicus's little jests. A wizard named Sebastian Lord had a daughter who worshipped Hercene. When the daughter became a werewolf, it drove Sebastian over the edge. He couldn't stand to see his little girl take on such a bestial form. The wizard wished for the ability to end his daughter's curse. Clavicus gave him an axe. Thank you.
Yeah! I have to
Let
wonder.
Let me guess. Someone
what does
stole
the Dragonborn
your sweet
do once he's summoned by the Greybeards? And if the one be taught, like any skill.
What is it, Argonian?
Welcome to the Villamere Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Is it absolutely necessary for you to bother? You don't look like a pilgrim. Why bother visiting Iverstead? Klimek brings food supplies up to them once every few weeks, when the weather permits it. Other than that, they seem like a quiet lot. Don't really know too much about them. What a boring conversation.
Pardon me, my lord. Would you care to hear me play my lute? If you fancy a bit of music, let me know. A pleasant journey, my lord.
I think you should continue with your performances. I think you play beautifully. It would be a shame if you stopped.
I've always fancied a journey up the 7,000 steps to the monastery. Anything to break the boredom of living in this town. I envy you.
No, I'll tell you, Wilhelm. If I could sweep
A pleasant away journey, my lord.
I'd do it. But Klimek still has so much to learn.
Klimek is doing just
Need
fine.
Need something?
You should follow your heart.
Perhaps one day, but not today.
Huh?
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted. There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away. Look, I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul. Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow? If you think there's anything you can do, be my guest. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter. Let's sate that appetite, hmm? Take a look. The Greybeards are a solitary lot. I don't think they've ever ventured outside their monastery. We get the occasional pilgrim passing through here on their way to the summit, but almost all of them have returned disappointed. Sir. I've got no interest in magic, you. I don't even like our Jarl having a court wizard. About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through. Said he was some kind of a treasure hunter. I warned him not to go in there, just like I warned you. The very next night, we heard screams from the barrow, and that was it. We never saw him again. Keep your eyes open in the barrow. That's how they get you.
Is it absolutely necessary for you to bother me right now?
What do you need?
staying safe, I hope.
My daughter's driving me crazy. So forgive me if I'm a bit on it. They call it the path to the monastery, the 7,000 steps. Can you imagine? I'm not certain if I could even make it to the top without collapsing from exhaustion. Just get out of town as fast as you can. Nothing for anyone.
Here for work? Get an axe and bring me all the wood you can chop. My business is falling apart, my apprentice never listens to me, and now there's talk of dragons. If I hadn't sunk every bit of gold I had into my mill, I would have picked up and left Iverstead long ago. Are you kidding? Those damn things will drive me right out of business. Tell you what, bring me 10 of their pelts from anywhere in Skyrim. I'll gladly pay you for thinning out the herd. The Greybeards stay away from me, and I stay away from them. Suits me just fine. Have you ever seen what a bear does to the trees? They jump on their hind legs and scratch them to bits, marking their territory or something. It's getting to the point where I have to scour Skyrim for untouched trees at the right size. Cost me too much time and money. Now go give those stupid bears what's coming to them.
On your way up the 7,000 steps again, Clivet?
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path isn't safe.
Aren't the Greybeards expecting some supplies?
Honestly, I'm not certain. I've yet to be allowed into the monastery. Perhaps one day. Passing through on your way to High Hrothgar? About to make a delivery up there myself. I've been to the monastery many times, but I've never even laid eyes on one of the Greybeards. Not that I'd care to. Being masters of the Thuum, they could kill you by uttering a single word. Well, not that they would. They seem peaceful, but I wouldn't want to provoke them. Mostly food supplies like dried fish and salted meats. You know, things that keep fresh for a long time. The Greybeards tend not to get out much, if you catch my meaning. Well, it's kind of an understanding between us. I mean, it just wouldn't feel right to charge them for a bit of preserved food. Trouble is, my legs aren't what they used to be, and climbing the 7,000 steps takes its toll. Really? Well, that would be kind of you. Here. Take this bag of supplies. At the top of the steps, you'll see the offering chest. Just leave the bag inside, and you're done. Well, there's the occasional wolf pack or stray, but that's all I've ever had to deal with. Shouldn't be a problem for the likes of you. Other than that, watch your footing. In these wintry conditions, the stairs can be treacherous. Be careful up there.